Hey, Double Eagle, how did your ice experiment go? Thinking about ice made me think about snowflakes. If you ever get a chance to look at snowflakes up close, they are really beautiful. You can use a piece of black paper or a sleeve or a glove, and sometimes you can see beautiful six-sided shapes. But what makes snowflakes form like this? You've probably seen hail before. Hail is little balls of ice that fall from the sky. It happens when big drops of rain freeze and then fall to earth. You might have also seen little tiny balls of ice that look like styrofoam. That type of snow is called grapple. Snow that forms beautiful snowflake crystals only happens when tiny droplets in the air freeze while they're falling. And as they're falling, crystals get added onto each droplet to make that beautiful snowflake shape. The water in the air freezes straight into ice without becoming a liquid first. That's why you can't make snowflake crystals by freezing water in your freezer. Instead of beautiful crystals, you'll just get blocks of ice. Ice is kind of weird, though. For one thing, it floats. Do you remember when we tested objects to see whether they would float or sink? Because ice floats, we know that it must be less dense than the water it's in. But most solids are more dense than their liquid. So why is that the case? Ice is made out of the same molecules as water. Molecules are just the little bits that everything is made of. You might have heard water called H2O. That's because it has two hydrogen atoms connected to one big oxygen atom. In this model, the big marshmallow represents the oxygen atom, and the two green candies represent the hydrogen atoms. Together, they make a water molecule. Water has billions of these molecules in it. In a liquid, these molecules can move all around and slide against each other. But in a solid, they literally freeze into place. And when they freeze in this hexagon shape. You can see it's the same hexagon shape that we see in snowflakes. You can also see that this shape takes up more space than if the six molecules were just sliding around each other. And that's why ice expands to take up more space than the water that it was made of. This structure where molecules stick together in shapes like hexagons or cubes is what makes crystals, like these borax crystals or this quartz crystal. We haven't seen any snow for a while, so today we're going to make snowflakes out of paper. You might have already done this before, but today I want you to think about real snowflakes and their six-sided structure. We're going to make six-sided snowflakes since that's how they appear in nature. So go get a piece of paper, a pair of scissors, and a place to put your trash, and then we'll make snowflakes together. All right, you got your supplies? First, we're going to make our paper into a square. Fold down the top edge to meet the side edge, making a triangle. Then we'll cut along this edge at the bottom of the triangle. When we unfold it, we have a square. But actually, for snowflakes, we want a triangle, so go ahead and fold it back up. Then fold this triangle in half again to make a smaller triangle. To fold it in thirds, we want our two sides to be about the same size, so don't fold it down all the way until you adjust both folds to be about the same. When the right edge meets this left fold, and this left edge meets the right fold, then we've got it and we can flatten it. If this is too tricky and you can't make it work, you can also just fold it in half and then you'll have a four-sided snowflake. Now, cut across here to form the outside edge of the snowflake. Don't unfold yours, but I'm going to unfold mine so you can see how this looks. How you cut that edge will determine how this outside border of your snowflake will look. And we could add lots of details to the snowflake by cutting along these edges. We just have to make sure we don't cut off a whole edge because then our snowflake will break into pieces. I want to make mine kind of like a real snowflake. You can do that too if you want. Here's some pictures of snowflakes to kind of inspire you. I'm going to try and make the snowflake have arms by cutting off part of one edge like this. And I can add a few more details here. You can do something similar or make your own design. It's up to you. Once you're done with your snowflake, make sure you clean up all those little bits of paper and throw them in the trash. And then you can tape your snowflake up to a window or hang it up somewhere in your house. Take a picture and share it with your class, and we'll have a little bit of snow to enjoy, no matter what the weather is outside. I hope you stay safe, have fun, and keep making things.